Gloria Keh. So happy to have you here today. Just going to have a chat with her about her art and inspirations. I do understand that charity has been a very important principle, rather, instead of a passion for you. Whenever I think of you and your art, that comes to me first. You know, your ultimate purpose of creating, right? So could you tell us a little bit about how it started for you, charity and art?
Charity is because of my mother. She was very active in church. I did a lot of church work, you know. And mother would just take me along when she goes and do her missionary work in hospitals or teach Bible study or whatever. From a very early age, because she couldn't leave me alone at home, I was put in such an environment.
Right.
My father was an oil painter.
Oh yes.
And so because he's an oil painter, I was exposed to oil paints and art
naturally
from a very young
age. You were lucky
age.
Enough to be exposed to it.
So I guess as I grew older, in the initial years, it was a bit hard to do a lot of volunteer work because you had other commitments, other things that you had to do, get a home. But I always liked to doodle, and I always liked to play around with color crayons or anything, nothing professional. Then I started mandala classes in Melbourne because I was studying to be a yoga teacher there, and then somehow I hung around the Theosophical Society and came across this mandala class. That helped me a lot with my own spiritual development. Then my teacher said to me, why don't, when I go back to Singapore, do things like this. So it started off by going to like the spastic children and basically playing with paints with them, and then going to old age homes like St. Teresa's home, Ewa home, and for the old people, it was something for them to do. It gave them a calming effect, made them happy, they were more focused.
It was just therapeutic
I felt. And
I guess it becomes therapeutic for you
for
too,
myself,
right?
I think I benefit more than they did. It made me very happy to be able to prepare for the classes and you know, do things, and whether it's working with little collages for Mooncake Festival or something. It was very simple things, very simple, nothing
complicated. What has been your conceptual inspiration on your canvases?
I like painting pregnant women, and that obviously is not so commercially viable, as I found out.
That's a very subjective entity, and everything is relative.
My husband says, you know, if that's what you enjoy doing, you do it. I feel that it's very symbolic for me. Maybe because I'm childless and I have no kids.
Right.
Maybe it's because I'm an adopted child. But I also see the pregnant woman as not just giving birth to a child, but nourishing and sustaining the human race, you know. To me, it's very symbolic. It's very powerful.
It's an honor to have you as an artist in a special monumental tent that it was for the exhibition, which is entitled Power Symbol. Symbols of empowerment in contemporary art. How you have related to this entire concept of power and symbolizing that power? Would you tell me a little bit more about it? Through your artwork.
I think I'm also blessed in the sense that when I studied mandala art with my mandala teacher in Melbourne, she always emphasized a lot on symbolism. You can use symbols very subtly and not have to say something or draw something
loud
and very subtle. If I use the lotus, you know, it could mean many things. And to me, the lotus is a powerful symbol.
Just as
feminine as the pregnant woman. Ganesha is another one of the things that I love to paint. That to me is powerful because he's the removal of obstacles.
I like the manner in which you have combined a very pure personal aspect with the very popular mythological aspect.
It's important to understand the art, that exactly what it means.
Yeah.
If it moves you somehow, if it's something that strikes a chord somewhere, then you know.
You've achieved something.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. Super way of putting it. This is such a joy talking to you, Gloria.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.